Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you how to know if he's the one. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the quality man you want into your life as a direct result of stepping into the most alive, the most feminine, the most connected version of yourself, and without the need to play games or use any type of weird strategies. Now, a lot of women have high anxiety and go to borderline freaking out about knowing when a guy is the one. And if you look at maybe stories, movies, magazines, novels, they all perpetuate this myth that you should know the instant you meet him, like the ocean should part, the angels will sing, and you will just know in your heart that that man that you just met for a couple of seconds should be the one that you spend the rest of your life with. Now, I think that's a bunch of BS. Every now and then you get a human being who connects with somebody else and they have this weird premonition or they have this intuitive feeling that that could be the one. But for the most part, it doesn't have to be that way. So rather than having to rely on that myth to gauge whether the guy is the one or not, I'm gonna give you five specific ways for you to gauge when a man is the person you're supposed to be with for the rest of your life. Now, first one is going to be love in action. Love in action means that his words, his prose, his poems, his high ambition, his wishful thinking is important. But it's not a replacement for how he acts, how he connects, how he shows up, what he does, how he lives in integrity between his words and actions. Love in action, the way he shows you in real life, present, consistent ways of behavior, that tells you that the man is the kind of quality guy that you want to spend the rest of your life with. Why? Because I connect with lots of women who connect with a guy, it feels super exciting, there's high chemistry, and they confuse the high chemistry for he should be the one because I've never felt this way. The fact that you've never felt that way does not mean that he's the one. It means that there's high chemistry, which is good and it's important, but it's by no means the whole nine yards that you need in order to commit to someone for the rest of your life. Second one is you want a guy who's into self-honesty. Why? Because self-honesty is one of those things that is very similar to self-awareness. Why? If the guy is self-honest, he's going to be willing to share with you what his intentions are, and he's going to know if he can chew as much as he can bite or not. Why? Because lots of guys want to commit, but they're in no position to do so emotionally, time-wise, financially, in different ways. Now, if the guy is self-honest, he will be able to be transparent with you and tell you where he's at in the process, what does he really want, and understand, be self-aware to know if he is in the same universe as the potential to be able to make that happen, or if he's on the five-year plan, where maybe you have a one-year timeline in mind and he's 5 years away from making something of a life commitment with someone. Third, generosity. And generosity means the ability to put his own needs back, not all the time, sometimes. Just like you have to be willing to do the same thing. It's not exclusive to a man. Both of you have to be able to be generous. And generosity means that sometimes you sacrifice, sometimes you compromise, sometimes you have to give more than you're willing to give in order to create that type of relationship that you're seeking. Now, I'm not asking for you or for him to go against his values, his morals, his highest ideals. But sometimes there's gonna be things he wants to do and he's gonna have to say no to those things in order to be able to create that commitment. Why? Because he might have the urge or the need to connect to more women, and he's gonna have to pull those needs back in order to create that monogamous relationship that you want. So that's just one example of many. Fourth, you need to be able to connect with a man and understand how he acts in times of stress in his own life and how he acts in times of stress, anxiety, fear in you. Why? Because lots of women have this high connection with a guy, super intense, very passionate. They never go through any big problems. They commit, and then when shit hits the fan, they recognize that the guy has no ability to stay strong or stay grounded in a moment of shakiness, or when she is going through a big problem, he's nowhere in sight to be seen. So if before you make the decision that he's the one, you have moments of trouble of some kind. You don't have to go through a tragedy, but moments of trouble, challenging times, and both of you are able to negotiate, navigate, stay strong, stay connected, be generous, be kind, be compassionate with each other, then he checks off one more box, because that's what life is. Life is unexpected challenges. Life is suffering sometimes. Life is pain in addition to greatness and happiness. And if a guy doesn't have the capacity to navigate stressful times by staying strong, if his default behavior is running away and you don't recognize that until you both committed to each other, now he's your boyfriend, or worse, your fiancé, or worse, your husband, and you recognize that when something challenging happens, he's nowhere. I mean, like, that's going to be a very challenging situation for you. Fifth, time. How do you know he's the one? You go through the first four steps and a few other ones maybe of your own. The fifth one is time. There is no substitute for time. There is nothing he can do or say or act, no intuition, no level of God-given signals in dreams that can replace the time factor. You spending time with them, you spending months and months and months getting to build a friendship, create a connection, navigate challenges, express what you want, fight a couple of times and bounce back. All those things are needed. If you feel yourself getting pressured by that default mythological, highly romantic, but very impractical thought that you should know very soon that he's the one, please stop yourself from doing that. You're doing yourself a disservice, and you're not allowing yourself to evaluate this in a way where you stand to win. Hope this is helpful, insightful, and useful to you. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Click the little bell if you wanna be notified of new episodes. Three, and most important of all, if you want to go deeper into this understandings and you want to learn how to create the kind of relationship that you want in a lot less time with a lot less pain, then on the first link under the description of this video, I've placed a masterclass for you that's free. Click on the link, enter your name and email, and you'll be redirected to watch that class right away. If you want my help, if you're saying, I don't want to go through years and years of trying to figure this on my own, second link under the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.